guys for being here with us. My name is Alexander James. I'm a youth speaker, minister, and I'm, you know, just a really good friend of UYWI. Mm-hmm. And I'm so excited to be sitting here with my good friend that I'm going to let introduce himself.
Hey, I'm Chris Gwaltney. I'm the chief executive nerd of Love Thy Nerd. You see here on my sweater. And we are a nonprofit ministry organization. We basically seek to love and serve our nerdy neighbors. So, yeah, we're here together. Alex and I have been friends for a while. We're both nerds, grew up gamers, big part of our life. And we wanted to, I appreciate you repping that today.
Yeah, man. I like had to do it. Did you have the big brick one or the Game Boy Advance?
Oh, I had a Game Boy Color. That was my first.
Okay, cool. Yeah, I had the big brick one, you know, the one you throw at your brother. But anyway, let's get into it.
Yeah, so we wanted to create this video series and kind of the PDF that goes along with it, basically in response to what's happening in our world today with this global pandemic, coronavirus. Basically what's happened is it's forced a lot of people and churches especially to get creative on how they reach people. And what a lot of churches are scrambling to do, frankly, is engage with their folks in an online capacity.
Right.
That's something that we as gamers have been doing. That's come first nature to us for years because we've been gaming online together for as long as we could. So essentially we wanted to create this resource for all of you youth leaders to be able to find better ways to engage with your students, to engage with your church community through the use of video games. So yeah, we're excited to be here and do that.
Yeah, man. And what I'm really excited about this is not only will this give a lot of churches just an incredibly expanded reach as far as who they can connect with, where they can build community. But I would also dare to venture that there's youth who are already at their churches, but just aren't really deeply engaged. They maybe they're more introverted, more quiet, and your normal church culture is going to lift up the kids that are more boisterous, more extroverted. But this is a way to engage, to broaden your reach, to spread out your net, to reach kids who maybe you aren't reaching more, and do that in a way that creates community, not only for the members you have, but for potential members of your community. So we really just want to put this out to equip people to serve who you have, but also to prepare the space for who you could have in the future.
Yeah. And I mean, a lot of people are maybe wondering, like, why bother? Why video games? Why does that matter? The reality is that people are playing games. It's bigger than it's ever been. Video game culture, just video games, is larger than movies and music combined, just in terms of dollars and people participating. So the reality is that the students are there. And so if we want to be able to reach them, we've got to go there as well to reach them. So the, you know, to put it in church terms, the harvest is plentiful, and digital. So we've got to go there and do it. Well, also, I'm going to drop some links in the description of this video to some articles that we have on our website on lovethynerd.com, that tell you why you should bother. Why does nerd culture matter? Why does anime matter? Why do video games matter? Why does Dragons matter? We've got lots and lots of thoughts on that. So we'd love to tell you all about it.
Yeah, man, I'm half listening to you. I'm playing a game right now. I guess that's the point, right? Is that the people we're trying to minister to are already playing these games. We just want to give you the resources and the skills to go to where these people are, they are, to respect and love their culture in a way that connects you to them, where you can actually make lasting, longing changes, right? So we thought about how to deliver this information, and we really just have these four steps, these four phases, thank you, Marvel, that we wanted to kind of roll out. So phase one is finding affinity. It's about like finding that thing, that game, that style, that board game, video game, mobile game, whatever it is that you and your community can enjoy together. That togetherness is phase two. It's when you find the thing that folks like, and then you create proximity. You simply like that thing together, which lets you allow them to walk alongside them. It gives you the opportunity to share your life. And when you begin to share your life, then you get phase three. You get to grow influence. People don't care what you know until they know that you care. right? So once the closer I get to people, I get the chance to show them my heart. They get to, you know, learn about me. I get to learn about them. And now that we've established some type of relationship, now I've earned the right to speak into your life, to encourage you, to pour into you. And that's where we get to where what's really exciting for me, phase four, where it gets to lasting impact, where now I'm raising up leaders. I'm raising up the captains of the game squad and captains of this group, and letting kids know that they can literally, from whatever age they are, be digital evangelists right now in this space. Because the question is, if the harvest is plentiful because it's digital, then we need digital evangelists to go into that space. So we're here to equip you to pour into them for lasting generational impact.
Yeah, and we're going to be unpacking these four phases in this series of videos. So we'll have some special guests as well that will kind of help us unpack some of those. And Alex and Alex and I will be in on those as well. So stick around, check out these videos. We've also, like I said, we've got the PDF, which we'll drop a link in the description as well. That will have a ton of information. And yeah, we just want to do everything we can to get this stuff into your guys' hands. It's stuff that we've been doing and have learned a lot and have a lot of experience, and would love to impart that upon you as well. So we're excited to be here, and look forward to being with you guys in the rest of the series.
Looking forward to it. Peace.
We'll see you.